5, 4, 3, 2.
Good morning, Beatrice. I'm Hunter Kingwell.
And I'm Matt Rizzio. Hey, Hunter, I got your nose.
Ow, man! You got me in a mousetrap!
Speaking of mousetrap, let's take it over to Prasanth and Jake with information about the upcoming school play, Mousetrap.
All right, so the Mousetrap is a murder mystery that's based in London, and it's based around this couple. And they decide to run a hotel.
And one night there is a huge snowstorm. There's a ton of guests that just come in and they all need somewhere to stay.
So you've got all these crazy people, like I play a really childish, crazy architect named Christopher. And then there's like this foreigner who's really shifty. And then someone named Major Metcalf, who seems to be like an army guy, but at the same time doesn't.
Suddenly a sergeant flies in on skis and tells them that a murder has just taken place and that a murder will take place inside their guest house.
We go through this mystery of who is the murderer, and it takes a wild turn and has some of the most craziest plot twists ever. People should come see The Mousetrap because it is one of the best plays ever. It's just absolutely riveting and super fun to watch. We have created some very unique and interesting things that are happening with this show that I think people who come to see a lot of shows really enjoy because it's unique and it's different. Also, it's student directed and our actors are absolutely fabulous. They put on some of the best performances that I've seen in Barrington High School, and they're absolutely killing it, and it's going to be absolutely entertaining for anybody to come see.
Yeah, directing other students is super cool. It's a super collaborative and unique experience because everyone gets to put in their input and everyone gets to put in certain unique things that they want to show in the show. And it's very cool because everyone gets very close and tight-knit and we really support one another.
Under a student director, I feel there's a lot more leeway. Obviously, I've known these people a lot longer than the director. Also, I feel like they're my peers. So it's not that I don't take what they say seriously, obviously, they're my directors, but I just feel there's more camaraderie there.
I really wanted to be a part of this production because I thought it was a fantastic storyline, and I really liked both of the directors, and I talked to them and I really saw their vision for the show.
This is a really, really unique show, and that's why I think people should come. It's really unique and fun, and it's really suspenseful, and there's murder, and there's love, and there's action, and so it really has everything in it.
Good. That was really interesting. I can't wait to see it.
Yeah. Hey, by the way, have you ever heard Hootie and the Blowfish singing in your head?
With a little loving and some tenderness.
And another note, here's a segment on graphic arts.
All right.
In graphic design, students use critical thinking and creative problem solving to collaborate and physically make innovative objects of design. In a student-centered, project-based learning environment, students will become proficient in Adobe Creative Cloud software through the creative development of self-interest projects. Projects range from skill and task-based digital challenges to using different materials, tools, and tech to make their ideas and designs a reality. We make cool things. Follow at WeMakeBHS to see more.
Wow, that was very cool.
Yeah, new life on my wrist.
Speaking of life, here's some info on Campus Life Fundraiser.
Okay.
Alright. I'm Brennan Trojan and you're gonna see some magic. So I need a volunteer. Can you help me?
I guess.
I just want you to tell me when I say stop.
Stop. stop.
Right there? Okay, yeah. Take that card right there. Show everyone, I want to see the card. Did you show the camera? Okay, show the camera here. We're gonna put the card right back in the back. Is that fair?
Yeah.
Is that fair? So we're gonna close this off just like this. Check it out. We should do this very slowly. Watch.
Okay.
It should hopefully move. And one card should come.
No way. Oh my god, yeah.
And that was magic. Come to Campus Life November 16th, 7 o'clock, and we're gonna have a great magic show for charity.
Thank you, Campus Life fundraiser. Very cool.
Matt, you know what time it is?
No, what time is it?
It's time to get you into watching Sports Desk. Okay.
All right. Good morning, VHS, and welcome back to the show. I'm your host, Ben Picorni, and today we'll look towards the start of the season for our winter programs here at VHS and go over our last remaining fall team's big upcoming weekend. It's November 14th, and you're watching Barrington Sports Desk. Starting out with girls swimming and diving, our last fall sports team still in action. Last weekend, the Phillies won their sectional meet at Stevenson, earning themselves a spot at state this weekend. That will take place at Evanston Township High School, so be ready for a great sidewinder on Thursday to send them off to state. And this week, two of our winter programs here at BHS will kick things off with girls basketball, starting it tomorrow night at Buffalo Grove in that tournament. That will run until Saturday. And also on Saturday, our dance team will be starting off their season at Friend. Barrington will perform at 11:30 and 3:50, so be sure to get out there and support them as they kick off this year. And today after school in the GRC, a few of our senior athletes will be signing their national letters of intent to their various D1 programs for their selected sports. Be sure to stop by to recognize these athletes and their accomplishments as they move on to the next level of competition. That'll do it for this edition of Barrington Sports Desk. Next week, I'll be joined by Barrington Sports legend Hunter Kingwell, the newest member of the Barrington Sports Desk team, to take a look at all of our winter programs, their highlights, and upcoming schedules. But that'll do it for now. I'm Ben Picorni, sending it back to the big men in the studio.
Okay. All right. Didi?
Good morning, BHS. I'm Didi Brustis, and it's time to get you in the know. For all baseball players, there'll be a BHS baseball player meeting Thursday, November 15th at 3:30 p.m. in the Business Incubator Room, Coach Hogg's classroom. The meeting should last about 20 minutes. Also, on Thursday, November 15th, will be a Barrington Buddies meeting held in the student cafeteria from 3:30 to 4:30. Latino Leadership is looking for small toy donations for their annual toy drive. This year, the toys will be given to Shriners Hospital or Laurie Children's Hospital. If anyone is interested in dropping off a donation, please do so in room W111 by December 11th. They're also organizing a thank you breakfast for our custodians and our cafeteria staff. Let us all give thanks for their hard work. If you would like to drop off a small breakfast item, please meet in W111 at 8 o'clock on Tuesday, November 20th. For more information, email Senora Rodriguez at berodriguez@barrington220.org. The Barrington Hockey Club Teacher Appreciation Night was a huge success. Thank you to all the teachers that came out to the special event. If you've ever been interested in photojournalism, think about joining the photojournalism class at BHS next year. This completely student-run class focuses on creating the school yearbook. Students work on photography, graphic design, writing skills, marketing, interviewing, and public speaking skills. If you are interested, contact yearbook advisor Tessa Reif at tcreif@barrington220.org for more information. That's all for this week, Barrington. Now you're in the know.
All right, that's all the time we have for today.